Right, leave it. Don't let the dog touch it. It's recording. All right, bend away.
Around the clouds that are illuminated, as you say, and as the temperature drops further, these clouds should shrink both in height and in width. So it might just clear up, and that gap that we can see the eclipse through now might just stay with us over totality.
Right, well, let's keep our fingers crossed. I know we've got 2:47 now until totality in Cornwall. Does that mean how long until we get totality here?
About 7:40 for us here, so we'll be about 5 minutes behind totality in Penzance for Michael.
Right, a real sense of excitement building here, Michael, but let's head back to Cornwall.
Oh, 2:24, John, now to totality. It's really dark outside. And this is the Isles of Scilly. Now, if we've got 2:17, they've only got just over a minute, haven't they?
They've got just over about 10 seconds from now. And we can see the crescent is thinned now. It's very, very thin. We can see the horns here.
Sugar on there, no more.
And this is when your hands sweat. The hairs on the back of your neck really get tense. Here are the horns drawing in now, and then we're going to see this fade all the way down to a single point of light. That's it, we're going to get the most spectacular show of Bailey's Beads as we go into totality.
We'll come back to that in a minute, John, but just here, look how dark it's gone outside here.
Isn't it absolutely wonderful?
Take your old little drop.
It really does, and we just lost the picture there, if we can get that back, then we'll see plunge into totality in the series in about 30 seconds.
Oh, right.
If we can get that back.
Can we still see the Scilly Islands? Because we've got about 30 seconds to totality.
We've got about 15 seconds now.
Whoa, that's really cool.
We've got 10 seconds to go.
Come and have a look at this.
What are you doing?
Disappears.
It's nearly, it's nearly full totality.
We're coming up here. Now
here's the Hercules, John, so...
Got a good picture in it. You can actually see it through here as well without having to strain yourself.
Yeah,
well,
you shouldn't be looking through that.
Well, it's not. It's very dull. You look. I've got zoom on and everything. Don't touch it.
Great shouting going on outside here. And at the radio. See it?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Hope nobody gets dazzled by all the flashes that go on. Tremendous.
And here's the issue.
Look, Christopher, look. Don't touch it, just look.
The horns going in again, coming down to a single point light, about 30 seconds
or so. Whoa, you're getting a good picture.
Totality,
then. Now it is done.
Not here.
It's all breaking up now into this final point of light.
But the lightning's coming on.
Just worry about the gloom descending.
It is quite extraordinary. Look at the atmosphere.
Now, here we've got a fascinating
picture. Look.
Here's the sun disappearing, here's some Bailey's Beads, and there is totality. We begin to see some prominences around the sun here.
And leave aside all the atmosphere and the height, this is what the scientists are looking at as well.
This is really wonderful. Now we've got midnight outside. Midnight at midday.
What's the series like outside?
Here's the corona now. This wonderful structure of the sun's atmosphere being twisted and contorted and heated by the sun's magnetic field up to several million degrees. The only time you can see it by now.
So this is the time when you can actually see what the sun does.
Absolutely. I spent 30 years studying this outer atmosphere, so for me,
Luke.
dark outside here, apart from just a bit of light on the far horizon, which is outside the zone of totality.
Because the total zone is so narrow, yeah. We're looking out of the zone of totality. Now we're beginning to see the lightning in the west as the total shadow is now passing over us. We've got 2 or 3 more seconds to go here. Totality is now essentially
how's
over
it there?
Here.
Yeah, it's good. It's getting thinner. Ben!
Out!
Have you seen what's happening with our darkies there?
What is it?
You can see it actually on the horizon.
And now, if we look to the east, we can see the shadow moving away. Patrick is probably about to come out of the shadow in Falmouth in about 5 seconds or so. And then the shadow is still heading eastwards.
This is the diamond ring, isn't it?
This is the diamond ring coming out. Isn't that beautiful? Mm. The most precious, the most elusive diamond that you'll ever see. Now we're back with the filter camera here, and then we can see the arc of the sun that's made. Those were incredible pictures from
today. Did it do as much for you as it normally does?
Stay away from the bag.
Unfortunately, seeing it here on the monitor, well, you can see I'll still smile. This has been absolutely amazing. And now the shadow
is
over the channel.
It's heading towards Patrick Moore, isn't it?
It's left Patrick, it's now heading towards Alderney. They've got about a minute and a bit to go before the total.
Hang on a second, John, let's see if we can see Patrick Moore, we can see how he reacted. Patrick, did you enjoy that?
Well, in a way I did. It was an eerie experience. From 10 a.m. past the middle, I'm all this spread up. Down here, unfortunately, and out ahead, we were under 10,000. The drop in the light level was quite amazing, more than I'd ever known before, and the rise at the end, when it was at the end, was equally marked. It was a strange, weird experience, one that I don't, in a way, bear putting you through. Very slowly, you can see what was quite clearly a magnificent story of the river. Your Taylor and our Skylight program later on, but at the moment, I feel that we have to say that from the past, we didn't have a story about a strange experience, and one that I think very few people are going to have again, but at least we have been through the last English total solar eclipse of the moon.
So it was really atmosphere you got rather than anything scientific or astronomical, Patrick.
Well, we got something. We got the tens we got, certainly, and the light drop. We got that, and some strange atmospheric effects, too. A strange kind of breeze I've not come across before. We learned something from it, because we didn't actually see it ourselves. And that's a great disappointment, but, well, we make the best of a bad job.
Well, there was extraordinary scenes outside here. What's that there? What's the atmosphere like there now, Philippa?
Well,
it's
teary.
We're very teary. Once in a lifetime, we had two, didn't we? You brought back a lot of memories, didn't it? We went back in time. It was darker than you said. We were looking at the beach and people were hugging and kissing and people were being drawing thumbs in the sand and it's just a very magical experience, even though the whole place is having fun.
It's very clearly, here's, this looks like third contact coming, there's the return of the sun. Just have a quick glimpse at those red spots, those are prominences in the solar atmosphere. We've now come to the diamond ring effect. And as it grows, can you see little blips on the end of it? Those are particular craters on the moon being illuminated.
And this is the final eclipse on UK soil from Alderney, isn't it?
No, it's left the
Scotland.
And we're giving it to the
US. Thank you.
And they can play with it and post it up further.
You can hardly
there's the prominences. But is this one of those rare opportunities to see what they actually are?
It's a rare opportunity to see them directly from the ground. And from the ground, we can deploy very much more sophisticated instruments. We've obviously got spacecraft, which aren't actually in orbit around the Earth. They're sort of orbiting the Sun, in fact, that give us some of the really super pictures in different sorts of ways.
Well, John, thanks. We were seeing what the site was from Alderney. We can go to Alderney and see what the people of the channel have made of it. Jamie?
Oh, dear. I don't think I've ever experienced anything quite like that. You can probably hear the crowd behind us. Did you enjoy that? Chris, I mean, remarkable scenes.
Jamie, we just stood in the shadow of the moon. I mean, I can't say more than that. It was travelling over our heads at 2,000 miles an hour. Everything went dark. There was this eerie twilight around us, 360 degrees. I'm so moved. It's the most amazing experience of my life.
Now, it's brightening up rapidly now, but explain to me, I mean, it literally came right across the channel at a rate, well, 2,000 miles an hour. And we can actually see that. I mean,
you could literally see the sky darkening behind us here. And this huge wall of darkness rushing over our heads and out, as John says, towards France now. The last eclipse on UK soil for 91 years is over.
Unbelievable. Day broke during the day. I mean, it really was one of the most exciting things I've seen. So now it's gone, it's off to France.
He says we'll be following it further on there over its course as it hurries across even as far as Iran and onto India over the next hour or so.
Right, extraordinary scenes. Thanks so much. Let's go back to Cornwall. Back to you, Michael.
Yeah.